Our next lecturer is Daniele Manga, referring a little bit about the organic issue of perceiving audio.
Thank you. Who has known about Manga, he knows that our topic is always time, transient response. And we heard a lot about high-res concerning the technical specification, the distribution, and But a general question is, what is your benefit of high-res audio? And so my question is, who have already listened to high-res audio? So, and what was your impression of improvement, change in whatever? Much better? Okay. So, and everybody speaks about frequency, and who hears about higher than 16K, 16 kilohertz or 20 kilohertz? Hands up. You will nobody find. So, you can say or ask, what's the difference between high-res audio? We're speaking about sampling frequencies like 44.1, which is the standard in CD. This means we have a bandwidth, frequency bandwidth, what we can reproduce is 22 kilohertz. With 96 kilohertz sampling frequency, we have a bandwidth of 48 kilohertz, so actually we couldn't hear it. It would mean that there's a change in frequencies. But if we look in the time, and time means that our ears are time detectors, there's a rise time change by CD quality from 22 microseconds, which means how fast the signal starts. And by 96 kilohertz, for example, we have a time resolution or a time response of 10 microseconds, and 192 kilohertz means 5 microseconds. And the latest research results in physiological researches is that we can detect 5 microseconds time resolution. So this means, actually, this is the answer, that our hearing sense have the possibility or the capability that we can hear this, but it actually means not that we can hear it, but we can perceive it and detect it. I show you now a little bit, not about technique, but about the hearing sense. So this is a general picture of the ear, the outer ear, the middle and the inner ear, and normally it always shows the basilar membrane, which is the sensor of all the time signal which comes to the inner ear. And this is the main sensors, the hair cells, the so-called inner and the outer hair cells. And the latest research results is that these are actually acceleration detectors, and these have the capability, and this is the great thing what our hearing sense or nature realized or developed, is that these very fast changes in time signals, in sound signals, can be detected. And this is now where technique comes and realize that the natural sounds or the reproduction and improvement in reproduction and recording side can be improved, that it sounds more and more actually natural, comes closer to the original. And this is that until nowadays, I would say the hearing sense is still the best. The best tool beside measuring instruments still is has a higher quality or higher resolution than the most measuring devices, if you know what you can do. So this is how the basilar membrane works. It's a kind of pitch, is so-called the transient response. But it doesn't show it really directly, because it actually has always two functions, that there's a dedicated place on the basilar membrane for the frequencies, but there's also always a measurement between left and right. So it's a little bit more complicated. If you look now at a transient response, it's an ideal signal. This is the starting point, and this starts for measuring between the left and the right ear. This is the rise time, where you can recognize the start and actually starts the character of the instrument. And the higher or the faster, we spoke about 5 microseconds, this means that is a very fast rise. And the continuing signal of the transient burst shows you the size of the source or the instrument. And there are also researchers where they cut this part in recordings and you can't distinguish the instruments. So you have just the impression you don't know if it's clarinet or a trombone or whatever, if you miss these. And this has always gives you also the answer why a DA converter by 384 kilohertz brings better result if everything works properly and high-res audio recordings sounds better in any way. It's always a matter of time. And I think I will be now at the end. I tell you a little bit about the Manga driver, because this was actually also the reason why the bending wave driver was invented by my father. He recognized that a normal loudspeaker is a mass spring system and you need a tweeter which has a light mass and a very strong spring, a mid-range and a woofer to cover the frequency range. But actually, if you look in time, you get 3 separated signals from 1 input. This is shown here. So this is the electrical input. This should be what it comes out, the transient response in air, because air is also a mass spring system. And this is what a 3-way speaker brings out. And this is what the Manga driver reproduces when the electrical input is like a step response. This is a cut from the Manga driver. This is so-called bending wand driver, and it has a multi-layer sandwich diaphragm. These are the pictures. It covers a wide frequency range from 100 hertz up to 45 kilohertz, which means also he has the capability of about a rise time of 10 microseconds. So these are our products. You can listen to it at room F228. And I thank you for your attention. Thank you.